I'm struggling it.
But the thing about maturing cider and whiskey casks is that you never really know what's going to happen to it. That secondary fermentation, which they call the malolactic fermentation, which is very desirable in red wine, can be a controlled experience for the cider, or it can be a wild malolactic fermentation. And basically, when you're tasting like scrumpies, the flavours associated with scrumpies, you could think of it in a way of sickness, cider sickness. So right. The wild yeasts have encouraged a certain flavour. What I found doing it in Scotland is that people aren't really in tune with those flavours yet. They don't understand them. We all understand like a peaty whiskey or smoked malt.
Yeah.
We all understand what it is to be smooth or the whiskey in the world of whiskey. Some of you must have been lucky enough to try poutine or something like that.
Oh, I've tried that as well.
Yes,
yeah. Very good. Loopy juice from Ireland.
But we don't get scrumpy yet up here. A lot of the old boys who've been in the military, been down in Somerset for training, they got it and they knew about it, and that was really, really nice to meet with them and talk to them. It brought back a lot of memories, So some of the flavours we get out of the whiskey barrels, peanut butter is one of the least attractive ones that we've had. So we'll have a look at this, Ewan, and see how we get on.
Okay.
There we are. All right. It's really good. Right. Open it up.
I'll give it a shot.
Yeah.
What do we do?
Go for it.
Go for it. I'm assuming the cork has to come out this way.
Yeah, but you have to bang that in as hard as you can before you get it out.
Down the side of it?
No, in the middle.
Oh, okay. Right. Mallet. Your public liability insurance is in order.
It's massive, it's 5 million.
Okay.
But luckily for me, employees, liability is 10 million. Hoy it up, and don't punch yourself in the face.
Is it best to twist it to begin with, do you think, Ross?
If you get it out first time, it's going to be a miracle anyway.
Christ almighty.
I think you just go...
Okay.
One, two, three. Hey!
Didn't work! You bollocks it off!
And the mallet.
We'll see a pro unit.
Well, it was this.
I didn't screw.
You remembered the banging, but not the screw.
Not the screw. I didn't screw. I'm really not good at screwing.
Go on then. One, two, three. Way!
Oh,
I tell you what. Let's try another one.
What about pulling up this?
Let's just leave that for the boys. For them.
Good luck, lads.
Good luck, one guys.
Yeah, let us know how it goes.
I'm going to open this. We don't want to muck up on
it. I think it's best you do that. Best.
Tell you what, it's good going. I'm nice and warm.
So this is round two. Peter's doing it because I goosed up this one.
This is actually feeling quite light. The angel's shear.
I suppose it would be a problem regardless of what you put in it.
That's true.
Ah, see, that's how it's
done. Well, hey. Right, there we are. So that's the whiskey cask open. To help our Google Analytics, legs akimbo, cider, bent over the barrel, hashtag. Yeah, it's delicious. Have a nice whiff of my bung bowl.
We're just whiffing Peter's bung bowl.
fine line.
He's only had this much cider as well.
There's a fine line between sampling and cider porn, isn't there? So now, I had scheduled in my book today a little bit of seeing how the cider's coming on in the whiskey cask. So as you're here, we'll just have a wee shot.
Fair enough. It's not because we're here. It's you know, he was going to do this anyway.
It's a cold day. We do this on a cold day. Cloudy, very, very, very lightly straw coloured.
Yeah, it's nice and clear.
Now, you tell me what you think of that.
Well, I can smell the whiskey cask, definitely, and you can still smell the apples coming through quite strongly. There's definitely the flavour of whiskey cask coming through.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good. Hmm.
I mean, it's a very subtle, it's quite a subtle, fine
oak-aged
cider. Can I seal this back up? That's an incredible colour for me. So I know what to look for in that, yeah. There we are.
It's good stuff.
Definitely.
Cask aged cider. I'd have to try it home, man. I've only had a little sip.
So that's that goes into the blend, which is just floating number 3 in Cider Summit, Chicago.
Woohoo!
Number 3. Just get tuned. Number 3 cider in the world.
There you are.
Oh. You nicking the rest of that then, Lee? Shake the camera up and down. Yeah, you seeing it? Okay, there you are.
Cheers,